It was the episode of Offspring that sent Australian TV viewers running for the tissues. Favourite Dr. Patrick Reed was sent to that great operating theatre in the sky, leaving Nina as a single mum to be. For actor Matt Le Nevez, it's been an emotional couple of weeks, but he's throwing himself into a new venture, and it's all about helping fight a terrible disease that preys on young children. As Dr. Patrick Reed on Offspring, actor Matt Le Nevez has spent a fair amount of time inside a hospital, but not as much as 9-year-old Rafael Morales.
Did you get that soccer ball earlier?
Yes.
Yeah? Where is that soccer ball, I wonder? Here it comes, look. You're going to hang on to that.
Raf has neuroblastoma, an insidious cancer that's the leading cause of death in Australia of children under 14.
Matt, having just met Raf, it's probably the best way to put this disease into some sort of perspective.
Yeah.
It's just such a horror ride for a little boy or girl, isn't it?
It's so tough. These young kids are affected from such a young age, I mean before the age of 5, and unfortunately because it's such a new disease, or cancer's not, but neuroblastoma we're still learning so much about, we don't find out that these kids have it until stage 4, and they're already under such immense pain and they don't really know how to communicate it.
How old were you when you got it?
4.
And how did you know? Did you have a headache or?
I had pain in my leg and then I had to go to the hospital, and then that's when we figured it out when we got the cancer.
So you've had it for a long time. How old are you now?
9.
What's the last 5 years been like for you?
For most of the last 5 years, it's been fantastic quality of life. Raphael's been coming here to Peter Mac and having nuclear medicine treatments, and they've kept his disease stable. It's just this year that he's had a massive progression of his disease, and we've had to go back to using traditional chemotherapies.
Neuroblastoma is a tumour that almost exclusively affects children, with 90% of the cases being seen in children under 5 years of age. It is a very common tumour that we see, a very common solid tumour that we see, and it usually arises from cells within the nervous and endocrine system.
Unfortunately, the disease is usually picked up when it's already very advanced. That's because it only affects young children who are too little to be able to tell you that they don't feel well. Matt has just become patron of the YAMS Foundation, which is dedicated to finding a cure.
As life's gone on and, you know, with something's like Offspring and you get a profile, you really want to try and use it for the right reasons. And I couldn't think of something better than trying to help YAMS. It's a new charity, it's a young charity, and we need to try and help them get their voice out because we need to raise more money for research.
How did YAMS come about?
You're My Sunshine Foundation is the legacy of my little granddaughter, Kalila. And Lil was diagnosed with neuroblastoma when she was only 2, and our lives were changed forever. And despite almost 1,000 days of treatment, she died with total skeletal cancer. And not long before she died, she looked up and she said, "I feel like crap and it's not fair." And I promised her I would find a cure. So I will never give up.
Matt will go to Phillip Island for this year's Australian Motorcycle Grand Prix to spearhead a fundraising campaign.
This is the first time I'm going to be in the country that this race is on. And I've seen them race bikes like this at Motegi in Japan and all around the world, and I can't wait to be here and watch it on our home track. And then also, you know, jump out there and smash this cancer, knock it down and start getting more money, because every dollar that they raised last year at YAMS went to research, and I know through Jude and Paul they raised over $100,000 and it helped him research for longer than 6 months. So if we can raise that, or if we can raise more, it's going to help find a cure for this cancer, and we can stop it in its tracks.
The treatment is horrific, and these children, they are so stoic what they go through, and they've always got a smile on their face. And it is horrific to watch, and none of what I do will ever bring Kalila back, but to save other children and other families from this nightmare is what drives me.
I'd love to chat with you as time goes by, and we'll keep following the progress of YAMS. And
yep, we're going to push it until we find a cure.
Yeah.
So that's our mission, and we're going to make sure we do, and I'll be down there at the GP screaming at anyone to give us a dollar.
Anyone wanting to help can go to yamsfoundation.org.au. That's all for now. See you next time.